نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. ليس لنا رب سواه، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, every one of us care about his business, his family, his income, and every one of us who has business care too much about his business. No matter what kind of business you are doing, you are follow your job and your business to make it bigger and bigger and better. And the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala is Allah. When he created us, he created the human being, he cared too much about us. When he gave you the days to fast, it's a reason for it. When he gave you the days of the Hijjah, it's a reason for it. So he's follow what he created subhanahu wa ta'ala to let his creation subhanahu wa ta'ala in very good shape. From the dua of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and Sayyidina Ismail, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala support the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by Rasulillah. Sayyidina Rasulillah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the last days of his life, he is telling us, taraktu fikum ma intamassaktum bihi, I left for you what you are holding, lan tadillu ba'dihi abada. Whatever I left it for you, and if you hold it tight, you will never miss guidance. كتاب الله وسنتي, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Holy Quran, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الزُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. O son of Adam, don't even give up from the mercy and kind of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He always forgive all the sins. And the ayah before, أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah give the risk for who he wants subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will able to. So no rush in our life. So why we are rushing for everything we needed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote it in his book. ويدعو الإنسان بالشر دعاءه بالخير وكان الإنسان عجولا. Human being always in rush. That's what we are seeing in our life today. Everything we need it fast, as soon as possible. We have one business, I need to be two. One house, I need it two. I have a car, I need two. I have son, I need two son. Two daughters, I need three. As how the people of human being is. عجول, تعجل, rushing all the time, while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning us from that, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, hold yourself not to be rushed no matter what. So while we are rushing our life, We ask in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time in his dua, in our dua. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we ask in ourselves, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept our dua? I'm keeping praying, I'm duaing and keep praying. And we, Allah never accepted from us. We make a dua for our brother and sister in Gaza day and night. And what? Why the wall is still running over there? Don't give up from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he let everything done with a cause. He has his word subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will lift them victor, inshallah. Your dua, you never give up. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if you are in rush for the dua, Allah will never accept it from you. You make the dua and you leave it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to understand our life today is being destroyed because we are in rush all the time. How many houses do you know they've been in divorced or breaking down because of rush action? You take the actions very fast. Fighting, you take the action. Go to divorce, go to the court, call 911, hold yourself. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if you are angry when you're standing, sit. If you are sad, just lay down. If you are not, just go make wudu. And then come pray to rak'ah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because the shaitan is behind you. The divorce inside our houses, not because we have an issue, no. The spouse, they love each other. Wallahi, they love each other. They make the opportunity to be together all the time. But when the shaitan gets in the middle, that's how the reaction is. And the advice of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and tasta'izu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. From the rushing, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the Fath Makkah, the tribes who entered the Islam, they have to pay the duty, the zakah. And when they collected the zakah, they sent a message to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, we are ready to pay our zakah. So he always sent a message, messengers with some people to collect the zakah money. So when the people in Mecca, they collect the zakah, they sent a message to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He asked Sayyidina al-Walid ibn al-Mughira and some people with him to go and collect the zakah. So he went there. When he went to Mecca and he saw the people of the tribe over there, they are on the top of the horses with the soul and the drum and just try to make him music and song and they are so and so. See, he was afraid. So he was in rush. That something is going on. They're going to kill me and the people behind me. So they are murtadeen. They left the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he returned back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, they are murtadeen now. They not follow the deen. They don't like to pay the zakah. So he was in rush to judge what he saw. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right away he spoke to Khalid ibn al-Walid, Saifullah. And they say, Ya Khalid, just prepare the iddah. Just make your arm ready and go and look at them. If they still want to fighting, fight back. While they discussed together, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Khalid, the messenger came from those tribes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Rasulullah said, why you are here? He said, Ya Rasulullah, we are waiting for the messenger, but he didn't show up. And they say, no, he was there, but you guys in the horse with the sword and your drum and you doing so and so. Say, Ya Rasulullah, look, our zakah today, we are counted by the bennies. I pay less or more, or exactly. Look what they have. They are so happy and proud by themselves. They collect the zakah, so they make us in a party in the top of the horses, welcome the messenger of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give him what they collect from the zakah. They are so proud, they are so happy, they make it a big party. But Sayyidina al-Walid, he took it in the opposite way, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he understood that. وَإِذَا جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَئٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا أَن تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ فَتَصْبَحُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلْتُمْ نَادِمِينَ. Deaf, don't rush, don't listen. If somebody tells you something about the other, say, no, let me search, let me look. Don't take an action right away. Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu arda, in his horse, he went to pray, and the top of the horse has some material. They sit down on the top of it, and he saw some man, and he said, be careful, taking care of it until I finish my prayer.
So the man, the shaitan blamed his head to take the tub, whatever in the tub of the horse, and he took it and he ran away. So he stole it. Sayyidina Ali, after he finished the salah, radiallahu anhu arda, he got 2 dirham. He want to give it to him as a gift. But he didn't find the man. Then he was laughing. He said, whatever he took, it cost these 2 dirham. If he's waiting, he will get it. But he was in rush. So rushing is not helping all of us at all. If we look at Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, after Allah saved him and Fir'aun and get saved, he was rushing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make dua. Allah asking him, Ya Musa, why you are here? Say, Wa ajaltu ilayka rabbi li tarda. I'm in rush, Ya Allah, to come, so you accept it. He say, Ya Musa, I left behind you, the people, he returned it back from your deen. Then he rushed back to talk to his brother, Harun, and he hold his beard. He say, what did you do? He say, I don't know, I cannot control it. So he was in rush to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salam, when his people disobey him, he was upset and he left them right away and he got upset. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let the whale just swallow him inside the ocean, but he reprinted back direct to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قِلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. He declared that he was made a mistake. He shouldn't be in a rush at all. The rush from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not good. He doesn't like it. He likes you to wait. You have sabr. You have sabr before any decision. Today, when you talk to your kids, you have to have patience, sabr. Listen to them, talk to them. You don't need them to run away from the house. You don't need to fight with your wife and the wife with her husband because we are rushing. Now, everybody look at the others with a jealousy. Why you are rushing for? This is your risk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote something, that's what you get no matter what. Is'a kama shi't. Run as much as you can. You're not going to get more than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to you. So the risk from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ummina Maryam alayha salam, she was in rush. When she got the time of the delivery, she was crying. And she speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did she say? Ya laytani mittu qabla hadha wa kuntu nasyan mansiya. I wish I die before that and I'm not in this world anymore. She doesn't know that what she carry inside her, Isa alayhi salam, Rasulullah, the one who spoke with his baby, the one who is Allah, atani al-kitaba wa ja'alani nabiyya. Allah, make me a prophet. She doesn't know that she was upset and she was in a rush. So many stories in the whole Quran. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, we all know the story in Surah Al-Kahf with Al-Khidr. He keep asking question, but before he goes Al-Khidr, they ask him, oh Musa alayhi salam, who has no more knowledge than anyone else? He's a prophet, save me. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put Al-Khidr to show Musa alayhi salam, you don't have the whole knowledge. Al-Khidr has more than you. But he was questioning Al-Khidr every time, and he keep telling Musa alayhi salam, just sabr, patience. And he said, okay, 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, until he gave up with him. He said, just stay away from me now. You don't have that. You are in rush all the time. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Raham Allah, akhi Musa. May Allah forgive my brother Musa alayhi salam. If he has sabr and he's not in rush, we will learn more and more and more from Al-Khidr. So rushing can destroy our life. Money can let us rush to do a lot of things wrong. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he gives the rizq, today we talk about the rizq as a money. Rizq is not the whole money. Your life is rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your body parts is rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your spouse is rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your children is rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything you see by your own eyes is rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he never created us like an animal. He created us subhanahu wa ta'ala, we can see, we can think, we have wisdom. He created us not like an animals to do whatever they do in the street, or we eat from the street, or we eat from the garbage. He gave us the wisdom. He gave us a tongue to talk and to taste the food before we eat. He controlled the digestive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala care about us too much. So don't rush when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for anything. Rushing It's not in our deen, it's not in our Islam. You have to use our wisdom to understand. We destroy everything by rushing. This person, so go direct and fight with this person. You cannot do that. Hold your horse, mainly in our houses. Today, we see so many divorces, so many cases in the courts. We have an example in the whole masajid. Very high title, intelligent people, very wealthy, but the money come in the middle. They have a small apartment, they move to the big house, then the wife, she said, now I see the neighbor is different neighbor. They have the Benz car, BMW, why I have Nissan and whatever it is? I need BMW, that's fine. I need the money under my name in the bank. Here, you can stop. It's not your money. I work for it. The fighting starts. The kids now, I see my friend in the college or in the school, they have car so and so and so, they buy so and so and so, but that's what we are destroying our life. A group of brothers, young teenagers, in the college, medical school, they're going behind one girl, not because they need to marry her or to do something bad, no. Her father gave her $1,000 a day for her expenses. Now imagine how much he is rich. So they go behind her, and I ask one of them, why you do that? She buy the grape as an example, and she find the seeds in such an, I cannot eat that. So they take it behind her. So actually, they leave behind her food. We destroy ourselves. We need to teach our kids. What is it? This is limited. This is life. You can get sick easy. You don't show off with the others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us in different categories, different income. We don't need to show off in front of the people. We destroy our kids by showing that. We have to teach our kids. You cannot do that. When you get something, share it with the other before they're looking for it. Because you can eat that and you get sick. It's a jealousy. That's in the Quran. Al-hasad, jealousy, in the Quran. It happened a lot. People, they don't mean anything, but they look at you because you have so-and-so, you're getting sick, and you don't know why. You don't know why you're getting sick. And we all know the story about the woman that's in her daughter marriage the day she was, the daughter got blind. The daughter got blind in her day of marriage. But nobody knows what happened. Until years, her vision is turning back. And then she, first thing, she picked up the phone to call her mom. That's now I can see it. They told her your mom passed away. So the jealousy come from mom. When they asked the father, he said yes. In the day of marriage, she said, she can deserve more better than this person. She's so pretty. She deserves a better man than him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take her eyes, her daughter's eyes, because of the jealousy even from their own family, from the mom. So be careful. Let the a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim in front of you all the time. Al-ma'udhat, astaghfirullah, subhanallah, alhamdulillah. Let your tongue wet by the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brother and sister in Islam, we need to control ourselves. We are in the society, so many people curse this country. This is a disbeliever country, a kafir country. Don't do that. Do you know how many people enter the Islam today in this country? So many after the war in Gaza, so many people converted to the Islam. What we are worried about it today is so many people who is Muslim original returning back to an outside the deen. They get out, they escape the Islam. They leave the Islam. That's our biggest problem. The estimate is equal. People enter the Islam equal the people who get out of the Islam. Our original Muslim people, they leave the Islam. In this society, you have to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the masajid around you. So it's not a disbeliever country. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them to become a Muslims and to this country to be a Muslim country. Every one of us here as a foreigner taking care of his family back home. And they curse this country. and we support them from this country. All the high titles in USA here, Muslims. The way I work in Queens Hospital, 200 and more medical doctors, all Muslims. During the month of Ramadan, we have no business in the hospital. We have no patients, mostly from Guyana as a statistic-wise, and Bangladesh, mostly. So in Ramadan time, none of them, they go to the hospital, so are very slow. And I'm laughing. I say, Alhamdulillah, we are Muslims. You have to learn this business, depend on the Muslim people. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase the Islam and the Muslim. The 10 days of the Hijjah, Wallahi alladhi la ilaha illa hu. We are very, very slow because most of the people fasting. Ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wonderful from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this country carried the Islam. And we enjoy our Islam. We enjoy our deen. We enjoy our salah. We enjoy our taraweeh. No one rush you to leave the masajid here. You are welcome to come and sit and revise and just reciting the hadith, read the book. Nobody asks you to leave. In our own Muslim countries, you cannot stay in the masjid after the Isha and the Taraweeh more than 30 minutes. And you call it the Muslim country. Over here, nobody rush you. So don't make dua against this country because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't like the people who make the dua wrong. The most important thing, the dua against your family member. Be careful, my dear brothers and sisters. When you have issues with your children, don't raise your hand and make dua. If Allah accepts it, it's going to be a problem. You hurt your family member. And the rush, let all of us come and run to the masajid right away. My son left the house, I don't know what to do. Where are you from that? Did you bring your son to pray with you? Where are you from the Jum'ah? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. He's talking to us. إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ جَمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعَ. Leave the work behind you and come to pray. Where you are from the halaqat, from the gathering, from the hadith, from the Quran. How you talk to your son, it's a mistake. Then, no rush. Hold yourself. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was in rush when people say something about Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha wardah. And he came to her, Ya Aisha, if you did it, istaghfirullah, make istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you didn't, that's, I don't know. So he was in a way, he is believe and not believe. So when she got mad and she left and she went to her father, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu wardah, and Jibreel came and he said, Ya Rasulullah, Allah free her from the seven skies. She didn't do anything. When he went back there to Balajais, was a little late. He was in rush. Then she refused to come with him until Sayyidina Abu Bakr got involved in the middle. But in the another incident, when he's fighting with her, he was in rush. When we have an issue in our family, keep it inside. If come out of the door, it's getting more problems, bigger problems. If you speak to somebody else, they will make the big deal. Don't listen to him. He is, she is. The problem getting bigger, mainly the family, because the family will take the side of the one who they love. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, when Rasulullah s.a.w. in rush and complained to him about Aisha radiallahu anha wardaha, he came to her and they say, Ya Aisha, are you disobeying Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And he started to raise his hand and the Prophet come in the middle and they stop like that. She come behind Rasulullah, protect me, Ya Rasulullah. That is the love. That's what I'm telling you in my message today. Spouse, you love each other, but the shaitan played the rules to separate you. Don't let the shaitan win. You are the winner if you come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Understand your deen, understand your sunnah. You marry by the book of Allah and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. So my dear brothers, inshallah, I can come a little bit front. That's so brother outside is waiting, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a condition we have to be in rush. No doubt. If you make a mistake or you did something wrong, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rush to make istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking you to come to your salah, you have to rush, pray in time. But when you come and you pray in time, you have to understand you are between the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sitting in the masjid and the man came to the masjid and he prayed and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, come, irja fa salli fa innaka lam tusalli. Go back and repeat your salah, you not pray the right way. So 3 times, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, this is the only way I know how to pray. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained to us, don't be ahead of the imam. Let the imam finish the takbir first. He go for ruku'ah, let him complete in ruku'ah. When in sujood, let him complete in his sujood. When he make the taslim, wait until he finish. Don't do it before the imam. He's telling us this. He's teaching us, take your time when you pray, because you are between the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not between the hand of the shaitan, the one who's rushing you. When the man came to Sayyidina Malik, and he said to him, I lost some so and so and I cannot find it. And he told him, go enter the salah. When you enter the salah, the shaitan will come and whisper, say, it's right over there. You're going to leave the salah and go and look for your stuff. But Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the opposite. And the sahaba saw him, he's rushing in his salah. Istajal, he was rushed. It's not Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stayed longer surah. It's very small. And he ran back to his house. And the sahaba look at each other, what happened to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why he's in rush? When he came back, he said, somebody give me amana to give it away. And I forgot, it was in my house. So I like to go back and give it away before I stay too long in my house. How many of people of us has amana and hold it, he doesn't want to give it back? So my dear brother and sister in Islam, when you have salah time, you have to rush for it. Mistake, you have returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away. If you have guest in your house, rush to give him whatever you can. If you are mistake with your family, go back and solve the problem, but don't wait. Don't wait. This is the only thing you have to be in. Rush. Rush toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the istighfar and the ma'udhat. And you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time to save your house from the shaitan. Don't leave your house without bismillah, tawakkalta ala Allah. Enter your house by bismillah, alhamdulillah. Then the shaitan will have no life in your house. This is the message from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my dear brother and sister in Islam, today please ask you kindly, don't be in rush in anything in your life. Life is not worth it. Today people, they are in rush for more technology to hit each other. Look at the environmental today. We've been eating foods full of cancer, chemical, because they are in rush to get the product back as fast as they can. They want to make it bigger. They inject it. We eat that. That's what they need to make money. But we are Muslims. We have to put the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us. We have to extend our hand for the poor and need. We have to extend our hand to the masajid. Increase the halaqat in the masajid. Listen to the shuyukh. Understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave his deen, as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تَرَكْتُ لَكُمْ مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِ لَن تَضِلُّ بَعْدِهِ أَبَدًا. كتاب الله عند سنة رسول الله. أسك الله سبحانه وتعالى to be among the عباده المتقين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا, كفر عنا سيئاتنا, اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا. اللهم لا تجعل هذه الساعة تمر إلا وأنت راض عنا يا كريم. اجعل يا ربنا آخر كلماتنا في هذه الدنيا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا وارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. اللهم يا رحمن يا رحيم, لنا أحباء في قبور, لا تجعل هذه الساعة تمر إلا وأنت غافر لهم يا كريم. اجعل قبورهم نورا. اللهم اجعل قبورهم نورا. اللهم اجعل قبورهم نورا يا رحمن يا رحيم. ارزقنا شربة ماء من يد الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة ونعيمها ونعوذ بك من النار وشرورها. اللهم حرم النار على أجسادنا وأجساد آبائنا وأمهاتنا وأهلنا وعلى كل من يحب يا كريم. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله, رحمني ورحمكم الله. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم. وأقم الصلاة.